Hello. It's been almost a year since I made one of these videos. There's some things coming up this time of the seasons that we live in. Because the time that we live in isn't measured by calendars, it's measured by seasons. It's not measured by years on a calendar, it's measured by the count of seasons. Those season counts start from the very first day of creation and continue all the way through to whatever the Creator's vision of life that He gave is fulfilled. But time is always measured in seasons and the passages, and each one of these seasons brings with it its own medicine, its own purpose. Now with winter come, some people say it's a time of letting go. And you know, there's a fire we're building in the longhouse here in a week or two, and to help people, what people would call let go. There's a time coming up on the solstice when the year sits down. When people say that when the year sits down, it's time to let go of some things, for when the year stands up, we don't carry them. And next month, our family is hosting something that people would look at it as a time of letting go. But Wawayas and I were talking this morning about some things, and one of the things she said that was very important, and that's one reason I'm making this video, is that letting go isn't but half of the teaching. It's knowing what to keep. We have to know what we're keeping too. That's what makes letting go whole. As people look at contamination of the spirit that came through colonization and the contamination of the lands and waters and the choices that we're all faced with and the contamination and the hurt of our spirits that come. We're wounded human beings. There's that trauma on the land and the water. And because we're part of that, particularly the indigenous peoples whose lands and waters are part of their DNA, where they're from, that trauma affects that living memory, that connection. And when we talk about our next generations and their future, what we're really doing is we're their past. We're their teachings they will remember. We're their history that they will look back on. So as we move into this winter season and the winter ceremonies and that medicine of this season that comes, yes, it's a time of letting go of what we don't want to carry forward. The things that have had their place to let go of. But it's also a time of knowing what we're going to keep. To consciously choose those things that we need to keep. These separations of mind between past and future and present, whether or not spirit world is somewhere else when we're living in the spirit world. All life is spirit. We're living in that spirit of creation. But as we start lighting these fires and we go through the mourning and grief that so many families experience, as we go through this time of facing the traumas that came, as we go through the solstice, the time of that sun and the season sitting down so that it can stand up again, and as we gather up in our many things that we do in the winter coming up, we need to know what we're going to keep. Because when you hold on and hold on with clarity and conscious thought of what it is that we're keeping, that's what we're holding on to pass on to the next generation. What is worth passing on is worth holding on to, it's worth keeping. And as we begin to understand more about what it is we're keeping and why we're keeping it, it makes what we're letting go of become more clear and easier to let go of those things. Because sometimes in life we begin to hold on to things that aren't helping us, that we don't want to keep moving forward. But we don't know who we would be without those things that we hold on to. Even though it's like a weight dragging us down. But part of that letting go is sometimes trusting and having confidence that the Creator loved us enough that even when we let go of those things that became so much a part of our identity, that they keep us from growing into being who it is that we'll be and who we need to be. So in this season that's coming, and these many things that are going to be happening in the next month for so many families, spend as much time looking at what we want to keep, what is important to keep, and keep it whole, keep it real, because that's the only way to make room when we let go for the things that we need to continue on. Thank you. Thank you for listening to this. It's you.